It's time for some home decorating ideas for less with our bargain hunter, Vicki Audette, and Sharon is with her. Sharon?
Right, Steve. This is the time of the year. It's getting a little cooler. You're inside looking around thinking, what can I do to this place? Right? It doesn't cost an arm and a leg. And Vicki is starting a special series today on what you can do around your house to really zip it up that doesn't cost a lot of money. Hi, Vicki.
Hi, Sharon.
Now, stenciling we're talking about today, is this a popular form of decorating?
Stenciling has become so popular in the last 4 years, it's unbelievable. You see it in all the decorating magazines, at all the Christmas boutiques. It's just darling, Sharon.
And it's kind of a country.
Real country, American country type of atmosphere. But the thing is, in the last 4 years, it has become very easy to do stenciling because they have improved the stencils. What used to be paper stencils, now they have these wonderful Mylar stencils, which make it a whole lot easier. And let me introduce you to a woman who is an expert in the Twin Cities. Her name is Alice Feldstuhl. And the thing about Alice, she does not only walls, but fabric and boards and everything. She is originally from Philadelphia, and she came here about 4 years ago, and she teaches stenciling in the Twin Cities. But we got a chance to look at her house, and we're going to show you that in a minute. Alice really actually studied some of the early American designs out east, and she brought those back and put them into stencil form.
Did she do that quilt?
She did the quilt. She did this whole master bedroom. Isn't that lovely?
Oh, my gosh. Well, yeah, it looks so professional. It looks like wallpaper, but it's not. It's all stenciled right on the wall.
It's all stenciled. Now, take a look at this. That particular pattern, which runs up the middle of the wall, took her 4 minutes.
No.
And the border, which runs all the way around the room, took about 6 to 8 hours. And she said that it took her actually 2 days to do the whole master bedroom. Now, it's very easy, and here's a beginner stenciling guide. You start with a stencil brush, Mylar stencil, and paint, and that comes to a total of $12.09.
So that's one stencil and one color of paint?
Right.
All right.
Right.
And you're saying it's not hard to do?
It's so easy. Actually, Alice showed me how to do it, and we're going to see that in a second. But the thing is that what's happened is you used to have to use special paints for stenciling. Now you can use paints, just regular latex paint from what you've used somewhere else in the house, so it's wonderful.
Why has it changed?
Well, it's changed, Sharon, because one of the things with the paper stencils, you had to use a special paint that wouldn't seep underneath.
Oh, under the paper.
Right,
sure.
And that's no longer happening.
Okay.
But it's not only inexpensive, it is also very easy to do. And we're going to take a look at Alice in my kitchen.
To stencil, the first thing you need is a stencil, and here's one of hearts, and we have one of a house. We're going to do this one in two colors, so we have a stencil for the house and another stencil for the windows. You're also going to need a stencil brush. We have two varieties here.
This is kind of thick.
Yes, it should be a good, thick, round brush so that it will hold a lot of the paint and stencil very nicely for you. Also, your work can be done a lot quicker if you have a big, fat brush.
Good, that's what I want.
Quick and easy.
Yeah.
The type of paint we use is a simple latex wall paint. You're going to need masking tape and, of course, paper towels to wipe off any mistakes you make.
Oh, I won't make any mistakes.
The first thing you have to do, Vicki, is rough off the surface of the cabinets. They've been painted with a high gloss paint, and the stenciling will not adhere until the paint has been roughed up.
Okay.
So stand just where you're going to stencil, in the middle.
Measuring is the next step. For some stencil jobs, this can be difficult, but on this kitchen cupboard, it's easy. Just find the middle and mark it with chalk.
The next step, Vicki, is to take the stencil in place using the guidelines that we drew with the chalk pencil. In stenciling, this is your most important tip. Remember to use very, very little paint. Dabbed out a little bit on my palette, and now I'm going to put a small amount on my brush and do the hula dance. Wiggle the paint around into the bristles and dab out the excess. It's very important to have just the right amount of paint on your brush so it doesn't run underneath the cuts of your stencil. Now we're ready to begin stenciling. Now, Vicki, hold the brush straight and stencil gently.
Do I pound?
Yes.
Can I go over the edge?
Yes, okay. Because yes. You have a little paint on your brush. It's not going to run underneath the cuts of the stencil.
Once I finished painting the first color of the stencil, the real surprise came when it was time to pull off the stencil.
And suddenly, there was a house. Then we positioned the stencil of the windows and chimney. To get the two-color effect on the stencil, the same blue paint was used again. But this time, I pounded harder to make the windows and chimney stand out. And then it was time to look at the completed house.
Oh, Alice, that looks great.
I'm so proud of you, Vicki.
It was easy.
And it took so little time.
A red heart was then added to the cupboard door. And once I got the hang of it, the job went fast. It took less than 1 hour to finish the kitchen cupboards. Here's how the cupboards looked before we started the stenciling. Pretty bare. And here's how the cupboards looked once we were finished. The house and heart inexpensively added a country decorating theme.
That is just darling.
Isn't that cute?
Yeah, I am impressed. Now, I'd be afraid, though, that I'd be making mistakes as I was doing it the first time on my own cupboards. Did you have any problem with that?
I was a nervous wreck. Did you see how serious I was?
You were
You know, we're talking about my cupboards.
Yes.
And I was afraid to make a mistake. But what happened is, it's washable. I mean, I couldn't believe it. I did make a mistake in the house. And we just took something like Lest Oil and a paper towel and wiped
it off.
Washed it off and started over again.
Oh, that's something. Now, where do you get the stencils?
You can buy the stencils at large paint stores in town. I know that Hirschfields carries them.
Uh-huh.
And if you don't want to do this process, you can have somebody do it for you. Now, actually, Alice does stenciling for people, and something like her master bedroom that you saw would cost about $300 to do.
She would come in and do
She would come in and do it. But you can also get referrals now from your local paint stores. It's becoming that popular.
Isn't that interesting? And she will also teach classes, doesn't she?
Yes, she does, at the Wyzetta Quilting Emporium. She's also written a book, so if you want to look through that, it's called the Early American Wall Stencils, and there are several patterns in color in there that you can take a look at.
Okay, but you'd suggest doing it yourself, I'll bet.
I really would. Do you know that now I want to stencil everything in the house?
Oh.
It was so much fun.
Next time you come in, you'll have clothing that's stenciled.
You're right.
Yeah, your whole face will be stenciled. Coming up tomorrow, part two, what are we going to do?
Tomorrow we're going to see how to strip...